transcended its own boundary. I will pay its homage outside India at your door. Tagore went to Iran and Iraq in 1932, and it is with a couple of anecdotes from that visit that I will conclude my remarks. In 1932, at Hafiz's graveside in Iran, the custodian of the cemetery had brought out a large square bottle of Hafiz's divan and asked Tagore to open it with permission and his eyes shut. He had been idolizing about the blindness and prejudice that went by the name of religion and wanted India to be free of this terrible affliction. Will the tavern's door be funneled, Tagore read when he opened his eyes, and with it, the tangled knots of life unfastened. Even if vain religious figures keep it shut, have faith that by God's will, the door will open. Now, first, Tagore translated tavern's door as heaven's door. He made it into
Similarly, in Southeast Asia, the
how could that be financed through Indian opium? Because the British were not about to bring in silver to pay for tea once they had solved that problem in India through their colonial conquest. But even a figure like Tagore would often encounter the story of the poor non-pointed migrant. So for example, he saw peace cooking tea used against poor Chinese in Shanghai in 1954. I talked about Malaya. He was not just having a conversation with the Chinese literati as I suggested. He was in Malacca and the labor leader came to him to say, you know the terrible condition of the Tamil laborers in the Dutch plantation. And the British were actually quite upset by Tagore's journey, and there was a false report that was published in 1927 that Tagore had urged Asia to prepare her army for a target which would be the heart of Europe. And he hadn't actually written anything of that sort. He had simply condemned the use of Indian armed forces against the Chinese. But the British rubber barons, who were rubber barons as well, did not really like the triumphal progress of this Indian voyage from the Malayan Peninsula in 1927. And so there were these idyllic aspects of that voyage. And then there were reminders of the far more grim story of labor migration.
Legitimize what